आई एम राहुल चांदेगरा फ्रॉम डिग्री इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट डॉक्टर सुभाष टेक्निकल कैंपस। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी स्टडीड सैम्पलिंग थियोरम, देन अलाइजिंग इफेक्ट, हाउ वी कैन रिकंस्ट्रक्ट द डिस्क्रीट सिग्नल टू द कंटिन्यूस सिग्नल एंड इट्स एग्जाम्पल। Today's our lecture based on application of IoT, it's Internet of Things and Arduino. The little introduction about the Arduino. So first we know what is the IoT and the Internet of Things. The term Internet of Things has come to describe a number of technologies and research discipline that enable the internet to reach out into the real world of physical object. We can operate any physical things from anywhere, anytime through the internet. So this is the latest technology will coming in the few years. So we can operate the domestic things, industrial things from anywhere throughout the internet. The everything is connected through the things is connected to the network with the internet. So we first study what is the Arduino. It is the open source electronic prototype platform. It is a one type of a processor. The content of this lecture, it is what is an Arduino, history of Arduino, programming environments, advantage, features, application, Arduino versus other environment. So what is an Arduino? It is a single board microcontroller intend to make the application of interactive object or environments more accessible. It is designed to make the process of using electronics multidisciplinary project more accessible. So Arduino is a one type of microcontroller which will get the digital input, then do the process with the microcontroller in very fast time and give the desired output. So Arduino can sense the environment by receiving input from variety of sensor. So through the sensor it will get the inputs in the form of digital signals, then it will be processed. Like one I will give you one example what Arduino can do. So it's there is a one sensor, it is a temperature sensor. So in Arduino programming we write if the temperature between 20 temperature to 25, then it's a normal. If the temperature more than the 25, then Arduino will turn on the AC. If temperature below the 20 degree, then the Arduino will turn on the heater. So from the sensor it will get the data of temperature, then the process of data within the Arduino it will compare with our desired values. Like if the temperature between 20 to 25 it will not do anything, if the temperature rise more than 25 then it will turn on, it gives the signal to relay to turn on the AC. After getting the temperature, if the temperature is below 20 then it will again operate the relay, it gives a signal to relay and relay operate and it will turn on the heater. This type of things we can do with the Arduino. The affects its surrounding by controlling lights, motor and other actuators. So actuator it means the something reverse of sensor. actuator will get as an input as an electrical signal and output as a displacement or pressure or anything. So sensor, it sense temperature, displacement, and give the electrical signal. But actuator will as an input as an electrical signal and give the output in the displacement. So sensor and actuators are two critical component of any control system. The brief history of Arduino. In 2005, recently, a project was initiated to make a device for controlling. A student built interactive design project that was less expensive than other prototyping system available at the time. The founders Massimo Banzi and David named the project after Arduino, and began producing boards in a small factory located in Leveria. So the programming environment of Arduino Uno can be programmed with the Arduino software IDE. It's an integrated development environment. So IDE is for different type of controller. There is a different IDE platform that have assembly language or assembly C language. So in that, the architecture of the controller based on that IDE is developed. The ATmega 328 on the Arduino Uno comes pre-burned with the bootloader that allow you to upload new code to it without the use of an external hardware programming. So if we write the program in assembly language or assembly C language, but assembly language we can understand, the user can understand, but the controller cannot. Controller only understand the digital code or binary code or hex code. So we have to use another program or another software that call a bootloader that will convert our program into the machine language, and the hardware, it's called external hardware programmer, that will load our program into the controller. But in this ATmega 32, it come with this thing. You can also bypass the bootloader and program the microcontroller through the ICSP. So it called in-circuit serial programming header. And the Arduino IDE works on Windows, Linux, as well as Mac for the Apple platform. So this is called Arduino IDE. This is the assembly C language to write its program. So this is one type of demo to write Arduino program. In this, we just typing hello words to the display. So void setup is our main program, and void loop is our another program in the main program to display continuously. So void loop is continuously display the hello words. So we will write this type of program in the IDE software to check whether there is error or any correction in this program, so we can do easily. So advantage of Arduino, it is open source, so there is no need of any license or no need to purchase anything. It is open source platform, simplified and user friendly programming language. no additional programmer or burner hardware required for programming board. It is a portable and low power consumption device. So this is the basic Arduino board. In this type of things will come with the Arduino Uno board. So there are so many Arduino boards. This is Arduino Uno UNO board. In this there is a USB connector, barrel jack, power ground header, analog pins header, 8 mega 32 MCU, it is called microcontroller unit. This is 8 mega 32 8 processor MCU. MCU is microcontroller unit. Reset button, digital pins, and the LEDs. So many Arduino coming with the LCD display. With it is called a study kit or project kit that interface with the LCD, LED, matrix keyboard, and many things. So we can type our program or we can display some letters to the LCD screen. The features of Arduino, it have microcontroller 8 mega 32 8, and operating voltage is 5 volt and 3.3 volt, and the input voltage recommended as a 9 volt approx. Input voltage limit is 6 to 20. Digital IO pins, IO means input output pins, so it is total 14 digital input output pins, of which 6 provide PWM output, it means pulse width modulation output, and there is analog input pins 6. Then the DC current per input output pins is 40 milliampere. For DC current for 3.3 volt pins is 50 milliampere. Flash memory about the 32 kilobytes for 8 mega 32, of which 0.5 KB used for bootloader. So bootloader is for loading our hex code to the controller. And the static RAM is 2 kilobytes. EEPROM, it is a ROM of 1 kilobyte, and the clock speed is 16 megahertz. So this is the features of Arduino. The most popular Arduino boards, so already I told you that there is not only Arduino Uno boards is available, but so many boards are available based on Arduino. So it is Arduino Uno, Arduino Leonardo, and Arduino Mega, then Arduino Duo, Arduino Micro. These are the most popular Arduino boards which are available for different application, different project. So most probably the many students are using Arduino Uno and Arduino Mega. So point number 1 and 3, that board are so most popular in compare with the other boards. So application of Arduino for the home automation, for automatically turn on the fan and the home appliances like fan, tube light, LEDs, TV, AC. So it is best for that application. Then the sensor prototyping for the robotics. Then the ISP programming, easy Wi-Fi, GSM, Ethernet, Bluetooth, Zigbee connectivity. These all are the features with the application of Arduino. Other prototype platform. So not only the Arduino, there are many popular prototyping platform are Raspberry Pi, then the BeagleBoard, Cotton Candy, APC Rock, Hackberry. So this type of different platforms are like Arduino. So Raspberry Pi is also famous like Arduino. Arduino versus other environments. So it support for analog inputs, limited computing power, comparatively cheap, no GPU unit. So it is global position unit, limited memory, PWM output available, so pulse width modulation output is available, and it is open source. So that's why this thing is make different than other environments of the Arduino. So Arduino is very useful. So we will study many things about the Arduino with the some examples of the project. The Arduino is a cheap and versatile open source prototyping environment. It is basically designed for non-technical people or technical people for different applications of the controlling. And its programming language is very simple. So Arduino has a terrific community support and documentation. So you can write your queries. So there is a terrific community support that will give you the answer and the solve your queries. Technical people can use Arduino for testing sensor or other prototyping work. Mostly the technical people use Arduino for controlling purpose. So where to learn Arduino? So the best way to learn from the website www.arduino.cc. So you can get the basic things about the Arduino, basic programming, introduction, architecture about the Arduino.